In the words of Don Vito Corleone, the principal character of Mario Puzo's The Godfather, if I have to summarize this project, Persuade with Power, it goes as such. Varun, you have to make an offer to this audience that they cannot refuse. And what Varun then, Madam General Evaluator, was take a very apt topic, that was the bicycle, the need to be on the bicycle, and ask us to consider becoming bicyclists, even if it was for one day. Now Varun, I'm going to synthesize or analyze your project in terms of content and then in delivery. Now the content of Varun's, your speech, contained the three ideas of why we or I must be somebody who must consider bicycling as a serious hobby. Not only will it impact the people around me, making the earth greener, it will also have a positive impact on me. I'll be able to save money as well as improve my health. Thank you for bringing that point to light and making me aware how out of shape I am. Now coming to the presentation, Varun, a persuasive speech requires that the person is, or the presenter is, fully convinced with the idea. And Varun, I felt that you at some point in time were not really sure whether this audience is going to accept the cycle or not. Let me tell you, many of them are cyclists here. You have heard their introductions as well. So they are your friends and they are willing to agree to you. So you don't need to go back or forth to suggest your idea. You need to go from left to right to talk to each one of them in the eye and say, cycling is good for you. In terms of the other aspect of delivery, it also requires that we have a certain body language that says that I am so passionate about this idea that I am going to disagree with my vice president education, and instead of appearing in a formal attire, I'll appear in a bicyclist attire and say that why bicycling is safe because I wear the protective gear. That presentation itself will sink in the idea that yes, it is safe. The other idea I might point out is also being able to appeal, because this is a persuasive speech. You can consider, I am just a student going through my final years, and I ask each of you, wouldn't you want me to have a healthier life when I reach your age? And when you see the audience nodding and yes, you know you have hit your point home. So may I recommend that when you take these ideas and make an inspiring speech, you consider organizing your project, your speech, having that central message that you want them to agree on, and instead of asking, do you agree, make your point with such emphasis that everybody nods in agreement, like you are nodding in agreement. So may I make an offer to you? When you go to inspire your audience, remember the feedback that you received from Project 1 to Project 9. Have a good one.